That's why, you know, our scripture that we go by here, it's transforming your mind. You got to start thinking the right way, the God way, with confidence, no doubts, that what he said, he will do. Next week, we'll continue this discussion on self-doubt. Please understand, the enemy doesn't want us to have confidence in what Jesus did for us. The enemy doesn't want us to believe that we have been made righteous by the blood of Jesus, or that we have the right to be forgiven of our sins. He especially wants us to doubt God's love for us, because this will make us question his promises. Does God love me enough that he's going to do it? Doubt. You're questioning. It's a sad thing, but we all face it. I don't think anybody's immune to it, but we got to recognize it and do something to overcome it, so that doubting doesn't become a way of life. Trusting in God is what we need. Let's look at it. Scripture that tells us that, and we'll end here. Turn with me to Psalms 118. Yeah. Okay. Psalms 118, verse 8, clearly tells us we have to believe it. Everybody have it? Everybody got their eyes on it?
Yes.
It says, it is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. Who are you going to trust? The Lord. Don't have confidence just because somebody told you, well, this is the way I think you should go. No, consult God and his word and believe that and go by that. Because he clearly tells us, it is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. And next week we'll go a little bit deeper into the subject matter of self-doubt. And then we'll look at how to overcome it. Praise God. Y'all guys give a little something. Start recognizing what self-doubt can do. It paralyzes you. It'll stop you cold in your tracks. And we've seen the Word of God. It tells us that it does. We've seen the way people reacted in the Word of God. Praise the Lord. He's so good. He's going to show us how to overcome this. And then it'll be up to each one of us to start applying it in your life. And it ain't as hard as you think. Okay? God didn't make stuff to be so difficult that we couldn't overcome. We are overcomers by the blood of Christ. Let's pray and we'll end this morning. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for your word, Lord. It points out so many things, Father God, that many times we overlook, Father God. Oh, glorious Jesus, help us to grow more confident, to grow more aware, and, Father God, not allow the enemy to put negative thoughts or questions into our minds, but to give your word full authority over our lives, Lord. We love you and we give you praise for all you do for us, and we ask it in your son's wonderful name. In Jesus' name. And we all said, amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.